So hi, Microbehunter here, and what does a Corona rapid test have to do with water microorganisms? Well, in this video, I'm going to explain to you a little bit how the Corona rapid test works, and specifically the solution that you use to suspend the cells and the virus particles that might be present. What happens to them when you suspend them in the little solution, in the so-called lysis buffer? Well, many of you, of course, have already done this rapid test. You have to take a small sample from your nose, which might contain the coronavirus, and you have to suspend it in this liquid. And this liquid is a detergent. A detergent, it works a little bit like soap. And what it does is it breaks up the virus particles and it releases the virus proteins. And then when you put the solution on the test strip, on the corona test strip, then you have an antigen reaction if the virus is present. But what I've done is I've taken some of the solution and mixed it with a water sample containing water microorganisms, and then I wanted to see what actually happens then. So I've taken my pipette, like the one that I have over here. It's a microliter pipette, and I've taken a small amount of the buffer solution and mixed it under the microscope with a water sample which contains those ciliates. And then what happened is that the buffer solution was drawn beneath the cover glass. It mixed with the water microorganisms, and then something quite interesting happened, not unexpected. Well, here we see those ciliates still swimming around more or less happily. The buffer solution has not reached them yet, but just after a minute or so, when the buffer solution is drawn beneath the microscope's cover glass, then all of a sudden you're going to see that the cells, they start to lyse. Well, those ciliates here are still fine, but lysis means that the cell breaks open and the cell's contents are spilled out. And this happens because the buffer solution contains a detergent that removes the cell membrane of the cells. And we are able to see this here. The buffer solution now comes from the bottom, and notice how some of those ciliates immediately start to break apart and spill the cell's contents. And I have been repeating this over and over again, and towards the end of the video I'm going to show you what happens when you mix human epithelial cells, which I've taken from my mouth, with the buffer solution. I'm going to tell you right away, the human cells are quite stable here. So look here again, look what happened. The buffer solution has reached the cell, and immediately the cells break open and all of the cell organelles are spilled out and are carried away. Now, I've also seen some paramecia, and those paramecia, interestingly, they don't break open so quickly, but they unfortunately, of course, don't like the buffer solution quite much, but it seems that they start to shrivel up a little bit, and I think this is a sign that there might be also some kind of an osmotic imbalance happening here, that the buffer solution might also take some of the water away from the cells. Now, the substance that is in there can also be found in other detergents, and however, it is a little bit different from other detergents in that the proteins that are therefore released, they do not denature. This means the problem is that with many substances that can be found in cleaning solutions, they denature the proteins. And this means that the proteins, they change shape. But what you need to do in a corona test kit, you need to maintain the shape of the virus proteins so that in the test strip, the antibodies are able to bind against it. And if the proteins denature and when they change their shape, then there is not going to be a reaction because the antibodies cannot bind. So the buffer solution here has to be one that is able to release the individual proteins without actually damaging them. And this is the reason why finding the correct buffer solution, of course, is not quite easy. Now, what about the whole issue about protecting the environment? Well, that is actually one of the reasons why you should not pour cleaning solution into the environment, because when they reach water, then the water microorganisms, of course, can be damaged and killed. Well, of course, I also wanted to check now the effect of the buffer solution on human cells. So I've taken a small sample of cells from the inside of my mouth using a toothpick, and then I also mixed it with the buffer solution in phase contrast. Here you see a gigantic air bubble, just ignore that. And you can see that the buffer solution is moving upwards, and you also see the very flat epithelial cells. And what happens to them? Well, I was a little bit disappointed. Nothing happens to them. They're so stable that they don't break open. But actually, that makes quite a lot of sense because the human cells have to be stable enough that they don't lyse, that they don't break open when you, for example, drink alcohol, because alcohol otherwise also would be able to dissolve cell membranes. Or soap, for example, on our fingers and our hands. The soap should not dissolve away the cell membranes. I mean, this would be a big problem because then the cells would die off. So it is kind of clear that human cells must evidently be a little bit stronger and more stable. Now, why this is the case, this can maybe be due to maybe the composition of the cell membrane, or maybe also, and that's a hypothesis, because of the so-called cytoskeleton of the cell, which holds the cell together from the inside. But I would say that this is a totally different story. I just wanted to share this little experiment with you. I hope it was interesting in any case. And now I hope that you also understand why it is so important to have this buffer solution to do the coronavirus test. Happy microbe hunting, as always, and see you around next time. Bye-bye.